اب میں ہمارے مہمان خصوصی مفتی محمد زکریہ پانچ بھائی صاحب کو درخواست دیتا ہوں کہ وہ انگلش میں ہم سب کو اپنی نصیحتوں سے نوازیں.
بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم اما بعد اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم واتقوا اللہ ویعلمکم اللہ واللہ بکل شیء علیم وقال تعالی انما یخشى اللہ من عباده العلماء وقال رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم طلب العلم فریضۃ علی کل مسلم او کما قال رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم صدق اللہ العظیم وصدق رسوله النبی الکریم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدین وشاکرین والحمد للہ رب العالمین. Respected علماء کرام, شیخ الحدیث حضرت مولانا حنیف صاحب دامہ برکاتہم, مفتی یوسف صاحب, مولانا قاسم صاحب, مولانا سلیم صاحب, مولانا زکریہ صاحب, and all the other great and respected ulama that are seated here, and at the same time respected students, mothers, fathers, parents, and all those are listening and participating. Alhamdulillah, we are honored Allah Ta'ala has given us the opportunity to participate and be part and parcel of this beautiful program, the graduation ceremony and completion program of the students of 2021 and 2020 that completed the studies of Dawratul Hadith from Jami'ah Masjid Abu Bakr. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts their completion, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not make this the end of their pursuit of and journey of knowledge, but rather may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this the beginning of their pursuit and journey of knowledge, inshallah. Respected ulama kiram, and obviously my mashayikh and my dear ulama, honestly, I am not in a position to say much, and I feel ashamed to speak, especially in the presence of His Maqam Qasim Sahib and Sheikh Hanif Sahib Damat Barakatuhum. These are giants of knowledge. And Alhamdulillah, I am very, very fortunate that I am able to access them, I'm able to sit with them and benefit them. May Allah Ta'ala prolong their shadow over us. وَلَٰئِكَ آبَائِي فَجِئْنِي بِمِثْلِهِمْ إِذَا جَمَعَتْنَا الْمَجَامِعُ يَا جَرِيرُ. The importance of these ulama is really only understood and appreciated when they are not in our midst, and we make dua that Allah Ta'ala keeps them amongst us. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. I was thinking for very long, ever since Maulana Qasim Sahib called me and said that you must come and speak on this occasion, and I was thinking for very long that what do I say? How do I address these ulama, these yani talibul ilm and the talibat, the girls that are finishing? But nonetheless, there's a few pieces of advice that I thought about, and when we look at the Quran and the Sunnah, and mashallah, like our student said, that there's so much that can be said. Where do you start and where do you end? Really, it's very difficult. But just a few words of sharing advice, first and foremost, inshallah, for my benefit, and then also for the benefit of our students, inshallah. You are completing your studies, inshallah. You've completed Dawratul Hadith, and now you're moving on into the next stage and phase of life. A few words of advice, inshallah, that you can take from this humble servant is that, number one, try to maintain ikhlas in everything that you do. Imam Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala, the very first hadith he brings in his kitab is the hadith of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, innama al-a'malu bin niyat wa innama li'imri'in ma nawa. Imam Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala brings this hadith to show us and for us to understand and realize that a noble pursuit like hijrah and migration, when a person lacks the right intention, such a noble dini pursuit can become a dunyawi pursuit. So Imam Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala is telling us that a noble pursuit like hijrah without the right intention becomes a dunyawi pursuit that's void of the reward and that is void of the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You sat at the feet of ulama and studied knowledge, and inshallah, we are very, very hopeful that you did that with ikhlas and you maintained ikhlas. But the important part is that this ikhlas is not only to be maintained now, but it is something that we have to maintain until we die. And we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah ta'ala allows us to do that. Number two, another word of advice is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you knowledge. Try and maintain the respect, the honor, and the dignity that comes along with this knowledge. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to say, ta'allamu al-ilma wa ta'allamu lil-ilm al-waqar wa al-sakina. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu used to say that learn knowledge and equip yourself with the dignity and the calmness that is required for this knowledge. So one is to learn knowledge, but with that knowledge, there is a charisma, there is an aroma, there is an awe, there is a certain level of self-respect and dignity that goes with that knowledge, and that is also our responsibility to maintain that. And that is why we always have to remember that we have inherited the legacy of Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as ulama, the legacy that we have inherited is inna al-ulama warathatu al-anbiya. وَإِنَّ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ لَمْ يُوَرِثُوا دِنَارًا وَلَا دِرْهَمًا وَإِنَّمَا وَرَثُوا الْعِلْمِ فَمَنْ أَخَذَهُ أَخَذَ بِحَظٍ وَافِرٍ أو كما قال عليه السلام, that it's not material dunyawi things, it's knowledge. And whoever takes a great share from that, indeed, he has taken a great share from the knowledge and the inheritance of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as I'm speaking, one of our students recently saw a dream. And I feel that I want to share the dream with the students here and for the benefit of one and all, that they saw one of their teachers giving them a box. And they said to the student that opened this box. And the student said that when I looked at the box, it was inheritance of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he says that I was crying, mezaru qatar ro raha tha, but I was not able to open that. This is knowledge. This is the legacy of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we really, really, really need to understand what it is that we are inheriting from Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number three, a piece of advice. Maintain taqwa. Wherever you are, wherever you go. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal and one of the other sahabi radiallahu anhu, ittaqillaha haythu ma kunta wa atbi'i alhasanata sayyata tamhuha wa khaliqi an-nas bi khuluqin hasanin. That fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you may be. By the barakah and the blessing of taqwa, Allah will open knowledge for you. Allah Ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهُ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. That when a person fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Ta'ala opens the door of knowledge for that person. And on that note, what comes along with the importance of taqwa is that because you are the inheritors of the knowledge of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, you don't just represent yourself as one individual. You don't just represent only yourself, balke you represent the whole legacy of ulama and ahlul ilm. And that's why when students amongst themselves, they normally say, يَجُوزُ لِطَالِبِ الْعِلْمِ مَا لَا يَجُوزُ لِغَيْرِهِ. The statement is wrong to start with, but nonetheless, it's famous within students, ki talib ilm wo kaam kar sakta hai jo dusre nahi kar sakte hain. But that was when you were in the chahar diwari of this madrasa. Now when you're going outside, you need to realize that you represent the legacy of ilm and legacy of ulama, which includes hadith, which includes Quran, which includes fiqh and many other sciences. And you have a standard that you have to live up to. To live up and represent the expectations of your teachers and the mashayikh that are giving you this responsibility. And inshallah, thumma inshallah, try to never let your seminary or your asatizah down. Number four, be humble inshallah. The hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, which is quoted in Muslim, وَمَا تَوَاضَعَ أَحَدٌ لِلَّهِ إِلَّا رَفَعَهُ اللَّهِ. That whenever a person lowers himself, humbles himself for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always raises that person. And so, although you are alim and you are maulana and you are sheikh and so forth and so on, don't consider yourself worthy of these alqab. I remember my ustad, great ustad and beloved ustad, Hazrat Mawsu Darwan sahab, damar barakatuh, whom we studied right from Arabi Awwal, right up until Dora Muslim, we studied by Mawlana Yusuf sahab. And he always used to say, ke tum apne yahan jaakar ke sheikh ban jaoge. That very quickly, and he used to say to me especially, ke tere yahan Canada mein to har koi sheikh hai. He says that everybody is a sheikh in your country, wherever you are. And subhanAllah, this is how we used to make our tarbiyah. So don't worry about these alqab of sheikh and alim and mufti and so forth and so on. We have to look within ourselves who we are and what is our responsibility. And for that, we need to be humble. Because when you humble yourself for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise your position. In English, they say that wealth, beauty and fame are transient. Wealth, beauty and fame are transient. And when these things are gone, then you look at yourself and you try to understand what use you are. Right? So wealth, beauty and fame, these are things that come and go. Right? One day you're famous and people are lifting you on their heads. And the next day you're not so famous and they will lower you. Look at the example of Hazrat Imam Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala. In last week's Bukhari Khatam, Hanif Sahib Nabrakatum, he shared the story of Imam Bukhari Rahimullah Ta'ala. That who was Imam Bukhari, but because of a misunderstanding in the masala of Khalqul Quran, the students of Imam Yahya Zuhali Rahimahullah Ta'ala, how they treated Imam Bukhari. So fame is something that is not within your control. You cannot control that. And not only that, I want to, you know, majasarat karta hu, I want to tell our students that don't be looking for fame. Don't look for fame. Don't put yourself in a position that you are looking for fame. Rather, look for acceptance in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the incidents from our mashayikh, Hazrat Tanwir Rahimahullah Ta'ala, which will always stick to my mind, and inshallah, I hope inshallah that you'll remember this. Hazrat Tanwir Rahimahullah is written in the Malfuzah of Hazrat Tanwir Rahimahullah Ta'ala also. Hazrat Tanwir Rahimahullah Ta'ala says that when they were studying in Darul Uloom Deoband, and they came to hear, rumors spread very quickly, especially in madrasas, rumors spread very quickly. So he said that we came to hear that the asatiza are preparing a jalsa for us. And hamari dastar bandi hone wali hai, jaise inshallah aap logon ki abhi dastar bandi hogi. So the Tanwir Rahimullah Ta'ala says that we heard that there's going to be dastar bandi, there's a jalsa, there's a graduation ceremony. So the Tanwir Rahimullah Ta'ala says that I went to my ustad, Maulana Yaqub Sahib Nanotwi Rahimullah Ta'ala. And he says, I went to my ustad and I said to him, ki ustad, humne suna hai ki kal ko hamari dastar bandi hone wali hai aur jalsa hone wala hai, aap hargiz aisa na kijiye. इसलिए कि हम उसके मुस्तहिक नहीं हैं और हमारे असातिज़ा की बेइज्जती और तौहीन होगी. This is who Hazrat Maulana Ashraf Ali Thanvi Rahimahullah Ta'ala. We don't know where to begin speaking about the manaqib of Hazrat Thanvi Rahimahullah Ta'ala. And so Hazrat Thanvi Rahimahullah, when he made this statement, he told his ustad, and he was genuine, he wasn't just saying it. He said, don't do this because we're not worthy of that. He says, his ustad Maulana Yaqub Sahib Nanotwi Rahimahullah Ta'ala, Hazrat ke upar ek wajd ki kaifiyat tari ho gayi. حضرت تھانوی رحم اللہ فرماتے ہیں کہ استاذ محترم نے فرمایا کہ اشرف علی کیا بات کرتے ہو, جہاں جاؤ گے تم ہی ہو گے, تم ہی ہو گے, تم ہی ہو گے. That wherever you will go, Allah will take work from you. حضرت تھانوی رحم اللہ تعالیٰ says کہ اللہ جانے اس وقت حضرت کی کیا کیفیت تھی, اللہ کی یہاں قبولیت کی گھری تھی. He said, wherever we went, Allah تعالیٰ took work from us. Right? But look at the attitude of حضرت تھانوی رحم اللہ تعالیٰ. And so the point is that don't consider yourself to be worthy of alqab, of fame, of position, and so forth and so on. Remember, my dear respected students, qubuliyat comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today we're worried about getting an acceptance from the public. Now, how many likes do I have on Facebook? How many likes do I have on Twitter? And this and that and so forth and so on. Qubuliyat comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Famous hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Allah ta'ala, idha ahabba abdan nada Jibreel. Allah Ta'ala loves somebody, he calls Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, and Allah Ta'ala says that, ya Jibreel, inni uhibbu fulan fa ahibbahu, that I love so and so, you love him also. Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salam loves that person, and Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam makes an announcement to the inhabitants of the heavens that inna Allah Ta'ala ahabba fulanan fa ana uhibbuhu, and you love him also, the inhabitants of the heavens love that person also. Fa yudau lahu alqubulu fil ard, and then Allah Ta'ala grants acceptance to that person on the earth. Qubuliyat upar se niche aati hai, niche se upar nahi jaati hai. Don't ever look for qubuliyat and acceptance in the sight of the people. Look to become accepted in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, may Allah ta'ala grant us that. Along with that, another word of advice for our students, maintain a very close and tight relationship with your teachers. Many a times we finish from the seminary, we finish from the madrasa, and unfortunately we think that now, main to maulana ban gaya, ab inse main kya poochun? How am I going to ask him? And it's not that you say that verbally, but our action says that. Our actions say that because we never go back, we never visit our satiza, and we don't seek their mashwara. Imam Shu'ba rahimahullah ta'ala, Khatib Baghdadi rahimahullah ta'ala, he's quoted this in Jami'u Akhlaq al-Rawi wa Adab al-Sami'. Imam Shu'ba rahimahullah ta'ala used to say, kuntu idha sami'tu min al-rajuli hadithan kuntu lahu abdan ma hayya kullama laqituhu sa'altuhu anhu. Imam Shu'ba, who is in the sanad of almost every hadith, he says that if I learnt one hadith from a person, from a scholar, if I learnt one hadith from this person, then I'm indebted to that person for the rest of my life. Wherever I am, whenever I meet him, I stop and I ask him and I pay my tribute and respect to him. If this is the condition of Imam Shu'ba based on one hadith, then respected students, what about the asatiza that you've studied the whole of Bukhari from? Bukhari contains more than 7,000 ahadith, and if you do hazf of mukarrarat, there's about 2,600 ahadith. If this is the position of one hadith, what about those asatiz that you studied hundreds and thousands of hadith from? And that's why, respected students, it's extremely important that we maintain a close relationship with our asatiza. Seek their counsel, try and be with them, and call them and serve them. They are the means of attaining the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are our ruhani parents. You see, every person, every child has, you know, two sets of parents. One is your biological parents, the parents that have given birth to you. And undoubtedly, they are worthy of respect, love, muhabbat, and all of that. But at the same time, the ruhani parents, those teachers, those asatiza that brought you today to where you are. So we must pay respect to them, pay tribute to them, be with them, and serve them as much as we can, inshallah. And finally, the last thing is that, alhamdulillah, you are finishing from Dawratul Hadith. Now, a very clear question mark, a big question mark in your mind will be that, what do we do next? Agla qadam kya hai? What are we going to do? You know, and you're looking at different options and you're speaking to different people. And in that regard especially, a humble request again is that please don't waste your time. Right? Many a times, if you don't have clarity of mind, clarity of heart, if you don't know what you are doing, then sometimes months are wasted, sometimes years are wasted. You don't want to waste months, you don't want to waste weeks, you don't want to waste years. Seek mashwara and counsel from your asatiza. And that's why three pieces of advice with regards to that. Number one, istishara. Number two, istikhara. And number three, istinsar. Number one, istishara, which means ask the right people that you are looking to, the field that you are willing to go into. Alhamdulillah, you studied ulum al-Quran, sunnah, and hadith, and inshallah, you will stick to this field. So seek mashwara from the people that are in this field, right? If you're looking to do imamat, then seek mashwara from those that are imam. If you are looking to teach, then seek mashwara from your teachers. If you are looking to go into counseling, then seek mashwara from those that are in the field of counseling. Whatever aspect of deen that you are looking to serve within, seek mashwara from these people. The biggest asset that you have is networking and seeking counsel from these people, number one. Number two, make istikhara. Make istikhara. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to say that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana yu'allimuna al-istikharata. That Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam would teach us the importance of istikhara the way you teach one another when it comes to Suratul Fatiha. Yani, on every occasion, istikhara was something that was common within the Sahaba. And it was almost second nature that when you're confused about what you want to do, you make istikhara and you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala will give you clarity of heart. Allah ta'ala will give you contentment of heart that which you are about to do, is that right or is that wrong? And number three, don't ever be shy of seeking help. Number three, istinsar. Number one was istishara. Number two is istikhara. And number three is istinsar. Don't ever be shy of seeking help. Whether that is, like I said, seeking counsel, or if it is financial help in a dignified, respectful way, if you want to further your study and you need to ask somebody, don't be ashamed of doing that. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will aid you and Allah will make your journey easy for you. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah ta'ala accepts your studying and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala considers us and makes us really, in the true sense of the word, amongst those that are warathatul anbiya. And may Allah ta'ala protect us from the trials and the tribulations that are there, that are present in our society. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us knowledge. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Wa sallillahu wa sallim ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
Bahut bahut shukriya ada karta hu Mufti sahab mein. Alhamdulillah, aapne Canada ki aam ulama aur khususan hamare فارغ ہونے والے علماء کو بہت ہی قیمتی نصیحتیں کی ہیں جو ہر ایک کو اپنے دل میں اتارنی چاہیے. جو پوائنٹ مفتی صاحب نے فرمائے اس کا پھر مطالعہ کرو, آپس میں اس کا تکرار کرو کہ کیا ہمیں بننا چاہیے, کیا کرنا چاہیے, کس طرح کام کرنا چاہیے. الحمدللہ انہوں نے جو گائیڈ لائن پیش کی, ابھی ایک ایک پوائنٹ ایسے ہیں کہ جس پر آپ حضرات کو بہت ہی غور سے آگے بڑھنا چاہیے. میں امید رکھتا ہوں کہ اللہ تعالی ہم سب کو اس میں کامیابی نصیب فرمائے.